Andreas. It wasn't you I fought. Try to believe that. If you can't, try to understand that what I have done, I had to do because I could not do otherwise. He shall be taken to Persepolis. He shall be buried in the tomb of the kings beside his wife. You must return to Babylon and break the news to his mother. I never thought it would end like this.
In a farm cart. You remember Gordium?
The knot on the wagon in the citadel? Yes, I remember.
The empire of the world in a farm cart. And there it is.
Yes, there it is. Darius, I took your mantle once. Now you must take mine. After all, I never did solve that puzzle, did I? How can a man solve a puzzle with a sword?
Alexander, King of Macedon, Captain General of Greece, Pharaoh of Egypt, King of Babylonia, Lord of the lands, great king of Persia, and master of the world, does hereby pronounce that you, Bessus, former satrap and prince of Bactria, have been found guilty of all the crimes of which you've been accused before him. To wit, first, that you did make an armed and treacherous rebellion against your rightful sovereign, King Alexander.
Alexander is not my rightful sovereign.
Silence.
And that you did thereby cause the death of many of his majesty's loyal subjects in the ensuing lengthy campaign. Second, that you did for the aim and purpose of making the same armed rebellion, usurp to yourself the false and sacrilegious style of Artaxerxes IV, rightful great king of Persia. Third, that it was you who committed the blasphemous crime of murder against the royal and sacred person of his late imperial majesty, Darius. For all these crimes, he does now sentence you to be taken from here to the city of Ecbatana, and there to be put to death in whatever manner the High Council of the Medes and Persians in session there shall devise. Bessus, former prince of Bactria, have you anything to say against this sentence?
I have a favor to ask.
Ask it.
I am a soldier. All that I have done, even the killing of Darius, has been done in fighting for my country against my country's invader. I am ready now to meet my death. But I would rather meet it as a soldier, not as a felon. Besides, possessing as I do a fairly close knowledge of Persian judicial customs, possibly closer than the present great king of Persia himself.
That's enough of that.
It is therefore not hard for me to guess the sort of death which the council of Medes and Persians may devise for a regicide. It will be, to say the least, uncomfortable. I'm not afraid of it. I would just rather not meet it. The favor I ask is to be allowed a military execution here in your camp.
The favor is refused.
So much for King Artaxerxes IV. God help him.
Alexander.
Yes, Gladys.
I think you might have granted his request. It wasn't unreasonable.
It was unreasonable. He killed Darius.
Well?
You seem to forget I'm his lawful successor. He nominated me.
In a delirium.
He knew what he was saying.
Well, who believes it anyhow?
No one yet, but the whole world will.
I don't see why it's so important.
Do you want to get home, Clytus?
You know I do.
Yes, I know you do. I know that all of you do. Now that Darius is dead and Bessus is captured and we're all of us rich, why can't we go home? That's what you're all asking when I'm not there.
Sir,
and don't trouble to deny it, Ptolemy. My ways of finding these things out, I need to have. Now, gentlemen, I take it you've received your orders for our march into Samarkand. By the first days of spring, we must be ready to cross the mountains into India.
India? So the rumors are true?
Yes, Ptolemy, the rumors are true. And what comments have you to make?
None, sir, none at all. Except that I'm informed the Indians are rather numerous.
So were the Persians.
India, ye gods, now we'll never get home. I thought as much. I don't know what my poor wife's going to say.
In Samarkand, I shall have my plan of campaign ready. We can discuss it then. Now, gentlemen, is there anything else?
Yes, sir. I've had a report this morning from Bactria. Serious, I'm afraid. Our garrison at Herat has been wiped out by rebels, led by a powerful Bactrian chieftain.
Not Oxiates.
Yes.
Why, the old rat and I negotiated terms with him.
Ptolemy, organize a punitive expedition. In view of the march into India, Herat must be made safe.
Yes, sir.
Is there no way of pacifying this devil's country?
Did you not take hostages from this man?
Yes, sir, I took his daughter.
Throw him ahead, then, as a present. Where is she, in the camp?
Yes, sir, as a matter of fact, she's... From Turner.
I imagine, sir, you'll be retracting that order you made just now.
Why should you imagine that?
Well, sir, in the circumstances...
Her father is a traitor. Her life is forfeit. No circumstance can alter that.
You heard that, my girl? I'm sorry, but your father's been a wicked man.
I doubt if she understands Greek or Persian. Probably only speaks some weird mountain dialect.
It's a pretty enough face, I will say. Well, this is a sad business.
The murder of my garrison was a sad business, too.
Of course it was, sir, of course it was. But you know, the killing of hostages doesn't seem to do much good in this part of the country, does it?
It must be made to do much good. What do you suggest? That I send this girl back to her father with my blessing?
Oh, no, sir, that'd be stupid, but... look at that face, sir. It does seem a shocking waste.
We're wasting time. You're a soft-hearted old idiot. Yeah. Remember, we've 3,000 miles between us and our base. Clemency is a luxury we were able to afford in Babylon, but not here at the eastern limits of the world. Now, gentlemen, is there anything else?
Yes, sir. Just a word. It seems to me that Clytus was talking sense just now.
That'll be enough from you, young Ptolemy.
But all agreed the situation needs a pretty drastic solution. If there's a league between four or five of these mountain chieftains and they get across our lines of communication, we'll none of us see our homes again, much less India. Now, that's a development that could happen at any moment, and we've a right to fear it.
I never said I feared anything.
Quiet, Clytus. Go on.
There are two alternative policies, sir. Terrorism and conciliation. Terrorism has failed because we haven't enough men.
In the name of the gods, Ptolemy, what would you have me do? I can't make advances to the whole Bactrian race.
That's exactly what you can do, sir.
What?
Through the very attractive person of this Bactrian lady. If you want to pacify Bactria in a few days, at no cost whatever, and for good, here's your way.
Ptolemy, you're surely not
Certainly
suggesting...
I am.
That Alexander should marry this girl?
Well, it doesn't have to be a proper marriage. I mean, at least not according to our rights.
King of Macedon and Emperor of the world to marry a barbarian peasant girl?
She's not a peasant girl. She's the daughter of an important Bactrian chieftain, a sort of princess in her own right. Aren't you? Hmm?
Oh, it'd make Alexander the laughingstock of the world.
I don't think somehow whatever Alexander did, he could be quite that. Besides, we can make up a very fine story about it. Love at first sight, chivalrous conqueror insisting on marriage, all that.
I'm glad you've remembered that the prospective bridegroom might be expected to have some say in the matter.
Of course, sir. Naturally, it's for you to decide.
And I shall, Ptolemy, thank you. Leave me now, will you? Have the next prisoner brought in.
Oh, shouldn't we stay for that?
No. I must see Philotas alone.
We'll better have the sentries in.
You insult me, Perdiccas. Do you think I'm afraid of an unarmed man?
A desperate man?
So am I, a desperate man.
Yes, sir.
Think over my suggestion, won't you, sir?
It would be a terrible risk.
Alexander, frightened of a risk?
Of this one, he is. I think I'll decide now.
Good boy. I mean, your majesty has made a very wise decision.
Think it over, sir.
Love at first sight, the chivalrous conqueror, or... Well, you'd have one valuable asset as a wife. You can't talk. Go away. Go away.
Alexander!
Ephestion?
Ah, thank God you're back. When did you arrive?
About an hour ago.
Well, you look well. Was it a troublesome journey?
It was a long one. You've covered a good deal of ground since I saw you last.
Oh, I shall have covered a lot more in the next few months. Why is he wearing chains?
General Ptolemy's orders, sir, a week ago.
Oh, dear, he gives such an order.
Philotas, will you believe me when I say I had nothing to do with this?
Yes, Alexander, I'll believe you. How are you, Hephaestion? You might have come to see me in prison. Alexander did, often. He even wept over me once. Of course, he hasn't been this last week to see me wearing my new decorations.
I couldn't have come. I've been in Babylon.
In Babylon? Did you see my father?
Yes. He sent many messages.
He doesn't know?
No.
Good. How is he?
Very well.
Have these things taken off his hands.
So it's true, then.
Didn't you get my dispatch?
Yes, but I thought that perhaps... I found it hard to believe.
Oh, I had no doubt you would. And what was it you thought? Perhaps.
I thought perhaps you'd had him arrested for a day or two to teach him a lesson. That he'd be free by now.
Philotas was arrested 2 months ago. His trial is next week.
He's guilty, then.
Of what?
Plotting against your life.
No, he's innocent of that.
Thank God.
Yes, I know him now to be innocent of that charge.
There are others?
Many.
Are they serious?
The High Council of the Army believes so.